current street seamlessly flow and integrate with the dash. You will see that the buttons are hidden behind the hood. You see that there is a very seamless way to transition from driver to pilot mode. So there are lots of this attention to small details in the design of the components and the interaction mechanism in the air.
And I understand that Nissan aims to transform the user experience not only on the inside of the vehicle, but on the outside as well. Can you explain some of that?
Yeah, absolutely. So customer, of course, so far, when we talk about the user experience, we always focused on the user experience inside the car as you're driving. We started talking about maybe on the mobile app, or wearables, or maybe at home with your, some devices. But the reality of it is that our customer is interacting with our brand, with Nissan, through multiple different interaction points. It is about the whole ownership experience. And that's what we call Nissan Connect X. And X stands for multiple different interaction points. You buy the car, that's one interaction point. You finance the car, that's another interaction point. You drive the car, or you need to service the car, you need to buy accessories for the car, you need to buy and replace components for the car. All of these touch points are aggregated together in one experience called Nissan Connect X, and that is what we are focusing on.
Okay, that sounds amazing and extremely convenient. So how will Nissan Connect services evolve in the future?
It will evolve in different ways and directions, but it's all about making the customer interact they can interact easily with the vehicle. So one of the things that you will see as we move in the future is the differentiation between the outside of the car and the inside of the car will continue to blur. It will continue to merge together and the experience will flow. We started this with door-to-door navigation, where you start the navigation even before you get into the car. Some of these use cases will continue to evolve and develop. One of the things also that you can see is that the use of speech technology and the natural language processing that we put in the car, the agent, the virtual personal assistant agent will be used in multiple different areas, not only while you are driving, but it will start showing up in some other touch points within the car. And you will see a lot of workflows that have to interact with the ecosystem outside the car. We started that with interaction and connection with the smartwatch, with the Echo devices at home, the Google Home. But you will see beyond that, there are lots of touch points in the ecosystem outside the car, and the car will interact with all of this. And then on top of all of this, of course, you will see the use of new technologies. So one of them, for example, like augmented reality, and how augmented reality can help the driving experience. We showed this year, last year at CES, the invisible technology and how this can help the driving experience. You will see more of that in the future.
Okay, we look around us and can see that competition is getting a lot tougher in this area. So what is Nissan's plan to stay ahead of the game?